Sazón del Fútbol.
Hello everybody and welcome to the last game of the group stage from the 2015 Copa America. Today we have two games. The first one, Colombia are facing Peru, and later today Brazil will be playing against Venezuela. So both of those games are very important because they will decide if Uruguay will have the chance to defend their title and if they will qualify as the second best third place team in Group B. So we'll have a look at the lineups in a second. Colombia are the second place team in that group. Peru are third. Now a 4-4-2 formation for Colombia. Gutierrez and James up top. Ibarbo, Cuadrado playing on the wings. Carlos Sanchez and Guarín are in the central midfield. Peru will be using the same formation with Guerrero and Pizarro up top. Vargas and Farfán playing on the wings with Fernandez on goal. Anyway, Peru have lost their match against Brazil with 1-0 as well. They have drawn their game against Venezuela, so they have 1 point and they are occupying that third place in the group. But now the first chance is for Colombia. Armero on the ball, getting it for Gutierrez. Gutierrez cutting inside. James now, James! And Fernandez with the first save of the game. Just a quick reminder for you guys to mention who is your man of the match for this game at the end. And you can mention it in the comment section down below. But now Armero finding Gutierrez. Now James. James does well to get past the defenders. The cross towards Guarín. The header is off target. Freddy Guarín missing the second chance for Colombia to open the scoring. And I'm sure they'll have much more chances until the end of the game, but we'll see if Peru will hold on, if Peru will manage to create chances for themselves. Now the chance, the ball in the box, Victor Ibarbo! And once again Fernandez, he has made two saves already, and we're in the 10th minute of the match. But now Peru are on the attack. Claudio Pizarro, Pizarro getting it for Vargas. Vargas in the box, the low cross cleared away. Cuadrado getting it for James. Gutierrez now will receive the pass from James. Rodriguez is against him. Gutierrez dispossessed. Vargas, all lost possession. That was a nasty tackle by Freddy Guarín, but the referee said that that was a clear tackle, clean tackle, and no foul. Farfán. Towards Guerrero. Oh, didn't manage to find Pizarro there. Zuniga. Mario Yepes. Zapata. Armero. Victor Ibarbo. Carlos Sanchez now. Gutierrez. Towards Ibarbo on the left hand side. Ibarbo cutting inside. Ibarbo. Ibarbo now in the box. James. James. The shot was deflected and cleared away. Retamoso towards Herrera on the right. Zambrano playing it long for Guerrero. He managed to reach that ball. Low cross, Pizarro! What a chance that was for Peru. And a good save by Ospina. Gutierrez now. Oh, that pass was a bit too long for him. Campuero getting past Cuadrado. Finding Vargas. Retamoso towards Jefferson. Farfán on the right hand side. Armero is against him. Farfán going past Armero. The pass towards, oh my goodness, the pass towards Guerrero, and it's in the back of the net. Guerrero opening the scoring for Peru, and this is a massive goal for them, because this way they are overtaking Colombia in the standings, and they will be taking the second place if the game finished this way. But Colombia don't need to bother too much, because If they are third, they will qualify because they have 3 points. They have 3 points, and yeah, they will be the second best third place team in the tournament. But now Ibarbo with a chance immediately right after kickoff, the shot was blocked. Anyway, a short reminder that two of the best, yeah, the first two best third place teams, it's a bit complicated this, but they will qualify for the knockout stage as well. Guerrero once again receiving the ball in the box, but didn't manage to have a shot at the moment. Mexico have 4 points, Uruguay have 2 points, and if we're watching the table live at the moment, Colombia will have 3 points, so Mexico and Colombia will qualify as the best third place teams in the tournament, and Uruguay will be out of the competition. So basically, Colombia have already qualified, and this game, the result from this game won't matter too much. Zuniga, Grado, what's James? James, still going, Rodriguez is against him, James! Straight at Fernandez. No stoppage time in that first half. There is the full time, the half-time whistle. It has finished 1-0 for Peru on half-time, but don't go anywhere because we'll be back in the second half, just like always. So we're back in the second half. 6 shots for Colombia and only 2 for Peru, but they are in the lead. Possession being dominated by Colombia as well. And the scoreline is 1-0 for Peru. Gutierrez now. Gutierrez trying the long shot. It was blocked in the final moment. In the first half, I told you that the result from this game doesn't matter for Colombia. Well, it does matter, because if Venezuela win against Brazil, it will mean that Colombia will be on the fourth place in the group. They'll be out. Anyway, offside for Guerrero in that situation, as we'll see on the replay. Close call, but the referee got it right. So if Colombia lose this game, they will be pretty. They will be supporting Brazil in the next one later today. James dispossessed, being challenged by two players with white jerseys. Guerrero once again. The goal scorer getting it for Herrera on the right. Farfan, Pizarro, Guerrero tackled by Guarín. I always say Higuaín instead of Guarín, but of course Higuaín is playing for Argentina. He played yesterday and scored a goal for Argentina, but of course today the player is Freddy Guarín. Romero towards Carlos Sanchez, Ibarbo. Ibarbo tried the pass for Gutierrez 2 times and both of his attempts were unsuccessful. Jefferson Farfan on the right hand side now with the attack for Peru. Jefferson Farfan, Romero is against him. The cross from Farfan was deflected off Romero and straight at the defender. He's the left back from Colombia. Carlos Sanchez getting it for Ibarbo. Romero once again towards Sanchez, once again Ibarbo, those three combining very well. Yepes, Cuadrado, lovely back heel there for James. Has some support in the middle, James, lovely turn by him. James still going in the box, the shot! So much power on that shot, but it was well saved by the goalkeeper. Romero, Guarín now, Zuniga, Cuadrado. Going forward, ball over the top towards Gutierrez. Gutierrez, he gets it into the box, but was tackled immediately and lost it. Guerrero now for Pizarro, chance for a rare counter-attack for Peru. And of course the pass over the top is too long. Guerrero is not able to reach it. Less than 15 minutes in that game. It is still 1-0 for Peru. And Colombia will be living on the edge for the next couple of hours if they lose this game. James being challenged there, but now once again James has the ball, trying to get past the defenders, and was closed down by two players from Peru and lost the ball. Farfan, less than 10 minutes remaining. Herrera, Farfan, Betamozo, Sanchez with a great challenge there. Gutierrez getting past the defenders. Now it's Carlos Sanchez on the left hand side, cutting inside into the box. James! And once again straight at the keeper. But Carlos Sanchez keeps it alive. The shot blocked by the defender and headed away. But now Guarín once again. They keep it alive. Cuadrado, Ibarbo with the rebound. It's off target. So many chances for Colombia. But once again they're not able to get the equalizer. Look at that shot from Ibarbo. I'm not sure if the defender cleared it for a corner. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's right, the defender got it out for a corner. Jackson Martinez will come on for Gutierrez for Colombia. The cross from the corner headed away only as far as Armero. 1 minute for stoppages to be played. Maybe one last chance for Colombia. Jackson Martinez, he was offside. The ball was going out for a corner, but he completely forgot, it seems, that he was in an offside position. Although it's a very close call, but I think once again the referee got it right, and maybe that was the last chance for Colombia. As we can see the timer, Pizarro holding possession, Guerrero, and there it is, the full time whistle. Peru have won the game against Colombia with 1-0 after that opening goal from Guerrero. That was the winning goal at the end. But as you can see, only 2 shots for Peru, 10 shots for Colombia, but no goal and 58% possession. I assume that the goalkeeper will be the man of the match. That's correct. Fernandez getting a 7 rating in that game for keeping the clean sheet. So many attempts for Colombia, but none of them was into the back of the net. Anyway, don't forget to mention your man of the match once again in the comment section down below, and let's see how things stand in Group C after this game. So as I mentioned, Peru will overtake Colombia in the overall standings, and now they will be on the 3rd place after that defeat. Peru are 2nd with 4 points, Brazil taking the 1st place with 6 points. They have qualified already for the knockout stage, but they will be playing Venezuela later today, and also that result means that Uruguay are out of the competition. If you watched yesterday's games, you will know that Uruguay would have gone through if Peru and Venezuela have lost their games. But anyway, Peru have won, this automatically knocks out Uruguay because Colombia are with 3 points and Uruguay are with 2 points. Anyway, if you haven't watched yesterday's games, make sure to do so. They are on our channel as well. If you enjoyed this one, make sure to leave a thumbs up on the video. If we get 5 likes on this one, it will be absolutely sick. Thank you very much, guys, for your support. And also, if you're new to the channel, subscribe. It will be much appreciated. And I'll see you later for another game, the last game from the group stage, Brazil against Venezuela, live on our channel. I'll see you then, and take care.